Explosion Investigation of Lesonate. This is my report about how the evidence is collected in explosion investigation. If an undetonated device is located, it must first be rendered safe. A bomb should never be moved from where it was found because it could detonate. This should only be conducted by a qualified bomb technician. Safety is a primary consideration. Damage to structure can be repaired, but injury to a person could be life-altering or fatal. To examine the type of explosive bomb technicians, use remote robotic equipment to take pictures of the device or even to detonate the bomb. Robots are commonly fitted with a device that can shoot a high velocity jet of water into the device, disrupting it. The bomb squad technician can then move in to confirm the area is safe, and law enforcement can begin an investigation. A bomb squad technician may also use a portable X-ray tool to examine a suspicious package to determine if it contains an explosive. X-rays are commonly used in airport to examine luggage to ensure baggage does not contain explosive device. Before being transported from the scene, all physical evidence is photographed, packaged, placed into containers, labeled, and secured. Evidence could even be lodged in the bodies of victims or suicide bombers. The bodies can be examined via X-ray image and the evidence retrieved if necessary. If a community don't have its own specialized unit to handle explosives, it will have an agreement with a Nervy bomb squad to handle these types of situations. Who conducts the analysis? Several professionals may be involved to examine explosive evidence or a destructive device. A chemist who is specially trained to examine items for explosive residues. These practitioners may work in concert with explosive device specialists who have knowledge of electrical components, expertise in device reconstruction, and an understanding of post-blast damage. In circumstances involving terrorist IEDs, the devices are analyzed by the FBI's Terrorist Explosive Device Analytical Center, TEDAC. TEDAC is located at the FBI laboratory in Quantico, Virginia. IEDs collected from around the world are sent to TEDAC for forensic examination. How and where the analysis is performed. Once a device is rendered safe, it can be analyzed like any other piece of evidence to search for leads regarding who was responsible for creating and deploying the device. If large fragments of device are retrieved, the DNA or fingerprints may be present that analysts can attempt to match to a suspect DNA profiles are compared to records in the FBI's National Combined DNA Index System database or CODIS. Post-blast explosive residues can be analyzed using a variety of techniques such as infrared spectroscopy, gas chromatography, mass spectrometry, energy dispersive X-ray analysis, Raman spectroscopy, and other techniques. Explosive devices can be searched against several national databases that are maintained to identify trends in the manufacture of explosive and track bomb and device designs employed by several bombers and terrorist groups. This database includes the FBI's Terrorist Explosive Device Analytical Center, the ATF's Arson and Explosives National Repository and the National Fire Incident Reporting System.